Hello, this is Monica from Add a Little Dazzle, and in today's video, I am going to teach you how to incorporate two of my favorite embossing techniques to create this beautiful notebook. In order to create this notebook, we are going to need some items. The first thing you need to do is purchase these little composition notebooks. Once you have that, you need to pull out the Lacy Brocade Impressions folder and a piece of Add a Little Dazzle metal foil tape sheet. It's 4.5 by 3.25. And I wanted to add some extra because sometimes when you're attaching this, you can shift around, and so it's easier to cut off than add on a piece. And so because of that, I added 1/2 inch this way and 1/4 inch this way. And so here is my piece. It measures 4 by 7, and this piece is what I'm going to use to cover my notebook. Okay, so here's my Big Shot and my multi-purpose platform, and it's open all the way. And I'm going to take one of my plates and I'm going to put it here. Now, the Lacy Brocade Impressions folder is longer than what fits through the Big Shot sideways. And so what I did was I took some scissors and I cut off that little piece right there so that I would be able to fit it through my Big Shot, because normally it won't. Now, in order to emboss this piece, what I did was I opened it and I placed it right there along that edge right there, and I closed it up. Now I put it right here, and I'm going to take my other embossing plate, put it on top, making sure that these edges are not going over, and I'm going to run it through the Big Shot. There we go. And we have this extra side right here that we haven't embossed. And so there's two ways that you can do this. You can, my preferred method is to take this and align this piece and find where it meets up and line it up and run it through the Big Shot. Or you can place it right here if you'd like and run it through the Big Shot if that doesn't matter to you. And actually, on this piece that I just created here, it fits perfectly like this. So I'm just going to do that like this. I'm going to line it up and I'm going to place it again here. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my plate and I'm going to put it all the way to where that edge meets. And then you can let go and it'll go through and it won't flatten anything over here. So here I pulled it out and here's my piece. Now you're going to notice that there's a little crease right there, but don't worry about that because I'm going to show you how you can remove that. So here's your piece and here's the notebook, and you're going to see again that it goes over, but honestly it doesn't matter because you'd rather it go over than under, because you can't attach more metal once it's done. And so I always prefer to add that extra piece so I have more room to work with, and then I can cut it off. So now that I've completed this piece, now I'm going to teach you how to hand emboss this. This is my embossed metal foil tape sheet piece, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to place it on top of one of the Stampin' Up! Acrylic pads. Now you need to make sure that when you purchase these acrylic pads that you only use it for hand embossing, because you don't want any scratches or anything on it. In addition, you're going to need Add a Little Dazzle's starter kit tool, and in this we include this refiner that will allow you to create the texture on here, and a deerfoot that's used for flattening. And so in addition, in our starter kit we have this piece of suede that comes in there. Now what you're going to do is you're going to place this right there, and you're going to place your metal tape sheet on top of it, and you're going to start on one of the corners wherever you choose. Let's do here a little bit of a bigger area, and you are just going to make in swirls just like you're scribbling, and you're going to start doing that into all the flat areas that is in this design. If you're pushing in too much here and you feel like it's too much pressure, you can remove it and work on the glass mat for this particular project. And so all I'm doing is I'm pretty much scribbling in all that flat area. And once we do this, we are going to cover it with black shoe polish to give it that beautiful antique look that it has. Come in closer and you can see right here that I've done that. And so what I want you to do now is I want you to do that to the entire piece. And again, you want to use the point of this. Now the great thing is that if you prefer to do it in a metal color sheet, you can also do it. And because you have this refiner tip that is made out of Teflon, you're not going to have the problem that it will remove the color. So go ahead and do that, and then I'll show you the next step. Okay, as you can see here, I've gone ahead and created all my little squiggly lines on this side, and now I've come to the seam. And so I told you that the seam really didn't matter, and what you can do here is just find a spot there and just kind of go in a circular motion and kind of blend it in to where you have a flat area to continue with the little squiggle lines. See, and it just kind of blends in, so it makes it look like it's just continuous in there. And so by doing that, like right here, even if you flatten it a little bit, honestly, it doesn't matter, because once we add the shoe polish, it will all blend in and it's gonna look beautiful. So all you need to do is kind of just flatten, find a little area you can flatten in a circular motion like that, and just kind of blend it in with the one on the other side. So it kind of looks like it's all flowing. And like I said, if you go a little bit off, it doesn't matter. Okay, so here's my entire piece. Now that I've done this, it looks absolutely gorgeous as it's added more character to this piece that we embossed with the Lacy Brocade Impressions folder. Now what you're going to do is you're going to get some black shoe polish and you are going to apply it here. And so I'm just going to open it and make sure you have something underneath to protect it. And what you're going to do is you're going to rub it in a circular motion. And you don't want to take too long to work on it because you don't want this shoe polish to set in. You just want it to antique it. And if you might want to make it darker later, you can do that. Now that I've done that, I'm going to take a paper towel and I'm just going to rub off the excess. So here's my piece and it's ready to be attached. It looks gorgeous. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this copy paper here and I'm going to take my notebook. Now, as I mentioned before, I made it bigger and I wanted it to be that way because it's easier to cut off than to add. And so now that I've embossed this and varnished it, I'm going to turn it over and I am going to peel the white film off the back. And this white film, the adhesive only comes on our metal foil tape sheets. And so what you are going to do is you're gonna put it about, maybe about a quarter of an inch right there on your notebook. And you're just gonna press down. Then you're gonna pick up your notebook and you're gonna go ahead and press down with the notebook to create that edge right there so that you can get it real nice and tight. And then you're gonna fold it over again and then press, and look how beautiful that's coming out. And so now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your scissors, and as you can see here, I have excess. And so now I'm gonna clean all that up. And then I'll be able to secure my edges using my bone folder. But I want to make sure that my metal is adhering to the notebook. So I'm going to take this bone folder and go over the edges of the notebook on both sides. And this will just make sure that the metal adheres real well to the flap. And then at that point, if you still have some excess, because now you've flattened the edge, then just go in with your scissors and just clean it up and just do that along all the edges. This spine right here is nicely attached. And then what I recommend is that if you want to add some more darkness to the texture here, then go ahead and add some more shoe polish and then remove it. And as you can see, it adds a beautiful antique look. You can either keep your notebook like this or you can add a bow to it. This is a really beautiful notebook that you can create using two different embossing techniques. Make sure to visit us at www.addalittledazzle.com, where you can purchase your Stampin' Up! Products and your Add a Little Dazzle products. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me at monica@addalittledazzle.com. Thanks and have a dazzling day.